So hello everyone, welcome to my channel, and as usual, here's another video. And in this video I want to talk about some sensitive topic, and it's about the mistakes some people make on the original entry, that is at the application stage around October there, when you are applying for your DV program. Sometimes, especially when someone else fills for you or applies for you, there is a high chance of some mistake coming through. So I'll be talking about that, and to be specific, I'll be talking about the mistake, like the spelling mistakes, date of birth mistakes, and all that. So, being a victim, personally, I applied by myself, that is the DV 2020. I made a mistake on the original entry, but I never knew. So, and I went through every process, and I will be sharing also with my experience. So, without much ado, guys, if you haven't subscribed, please do so. And if you know somebody who is going through the same, please share the video, let him join us, so that we can try and comfort each other here. So with that being said, let's start our video right now. So to start with, I would like to emphasize on those who are planning or are preparing to apply for the DV 2022, please do the application by yourself. Stop paying some other people to do it for you. It's pretty simple. You have your phone, you have your internet, just do it by yourself. It's very simple. Actually, it's the easiest application I've ever met on the online platform. So please stop using agencies. That's where the mistakes come through. So I hope you apply it by yourself. That is around October this year, around date 15, around there. So I'll be updating you when it will be, if it will be there, I'll be updating you on when it will take place and the process to follow. I'll take you through that. So let's go. And another thing is this: if you have a WhatsApp groups and all that stuff, you can share the video. Actually, I know on those WhatsApp groups, that's where there is a lot of questions, and maybe there's no one to help you out, guys. And that's why sometimes I receive several questions, several issues, and I decide to make a video on this. So if you have a group, share it. It's free. We are here to help each other and comfort others. So let's start it right away. So the issue of the mistakes, it might be mostly three types. One, name is a mistake, that is the spelling. The other thing, date of birth. And the other thing, some mistake from documents, like the education documents. The name in the documents are not the same name in the passport. So such situation can happen. And actually, in this video, I'll classify those mistakes into three. That is the single simple mistake. That is especially like it happens on the name, the spelling. Maybe the name like Muhammad have double M, but maybe you find that on your application stage, you wrote only one M. So there's an omitted letter. So a spelling omitted letter, that's a simple error or a simple mistake. So if all your program, if all your case has only that single mistake, we can classify that as simple one. And again, we can call it a low risk scenario or a low risk case or a low risk mistake. That's one. The next one is somehow more serious, and personally I was part of it, is where you, and again we can classify it as single, more serious but single mistake. That is when you omit a full name. Like on the original entry, maybe you have three names, surname, first name, and middle name. But you feel like, personally I did, I never knew what was happening. Up to this day, I never understand what happened. I failed, but when I submitted, I found my name was missing. My middle name was missing, omitted. I don't know what happened. My name was just the surname and the middle name. Sorry, the surname and the first name. So the middle name was missing. That is a more serious or somehow serious case or a serious mistake. That one you can classify it as medium mistake or medium risk. I hope you are clear up to that point. So if you're there and you missed your middle name or first name or even the surname, you should be not that much worried, because personally I'm a victim of that and my case was successful. So I'll be talking about that. So the other category is the third one, that is the high risk or very serious scenario. That is where you have a combination of errors. You have an error, maybe you missed a name, you have your dates are not matching, you have your several mistakes, like you omit a name, then you have your documents are not matching, the date of birth is not correct. So that's very serious. So those are the three categories, and then per each category I'll be explaining. First, I would like to make this one, not this one, I have heard of, or there have been cases, there have been scenarios where somebody with a very serious mistake, that is maybe combination of several mistakes, getting a visa. And again, there have been scenarios, there have been people with pretty the simple single mistake, but they ended up being denied sometimes, and always, actually always. It all depends with the CEO, that is the consular officer who will interview you at the embassy. He's the one to decide. He's the one to revise your case, look the documents one on one, and then conclude and make a decision on your case. So I can't assure you that, you know, you have a spelling mistake that you won't be denied. I can't assure you on that. And again, I can't like confirm to you that you have a very serious mistake that you automatically be disqualified. No. But there are some factors that, you know, you can think about. There is this factor, and it's very common. If, okay, whatever most what happened is this. If at the consular officer or at the embassy, if your country or your region where you are taking your interview, maybe in that embassy, there have been reported many cases of fraud. You know, many people have been trying fraud, you know, scenarios and all that. So the consular officers in that embassy are aware of such dramas, that, you know, fraud and all that stuff. If your country or if your embassy where you will be attending the interview, they have an experience of high cases of fraud, then even those petty mistakes, those single simple mistakes can be disqualified. You can be denied. You can be denied a visa due to simple single mistakes. Those are the low risk cases, due to that high, you know, high reputation of fraud in a specific embassy. So most affected cases are maybe West Africa countries, especially, to be specific, Ghana. If you are taking an interview from the US embassy in Ghana, make sure to avoid those petty mistakes. There is a high reputation of fraud in the US embassy in Ghana. Actually, around the West Africa parts, there are high cases of frauds and all that. So prepare your documents very well and avoid such mistakes. Again, what should you do if you have, okay, if you're there, you have your mistakes, you know, you cannot change. Actually, you know, if you did a mistake on the original entry, that original entry, if at all you never have some screenshot for you while you are filling or when you are applying, you can never access that original entry form. You can't tell what you filled and you can't change it. So you can't even access it. So we have to be clear on that. You can't access that original entry form. So even you just can't confirm what you did. You can't even change. Once it's done, it's done. So what can you do? What is the best thing you can do if you are in such a situation? Maybe the simple mistake, medium mistakes, or even the high risk mistake. Personally, I'll give you a scenario of myself. I was in the medium, let me call it a medium risk. I omitted my middle name on the original entry. Actually, I never recognized it. Even when I won, I found the surname and, you know, the surname and the first name, and I thought this is how the results come. So I just proceeded on the DS-260. I filled my three names, surname, middle name, and, okay, surname, first name, and middle name, all three of them. You know, in my mind, I didn't know that I omitted my name. So I proceeded, I submitted the documents with my three names. So personally, I was good. I had only one mistake. I omitted a name, but all my documents were correct and there was no any other mistake. So having sometimes a single mistake is better, but your documents are okay. That one can be understandable, that maybe you did a mistake on the original entry. So the best thing you can do is this. On the DS-260, that's where you change everything. And you don't change it to like change the documents. Make sure what you fill on the DS-260, all the documents rhyme or are the same with what you fill on the DS-260. So if you had omitted a name, make sure that the name you include on the DS-260 is the same name in the passport and birth certificate. So again, even if at the original entry you had a spelling mistake, you had a spelling mistake of your name, maybe capital M or capital letters, and you filled on a single letter or all those mistakes, make sure that your documents, your passport, your birth certificate, the school certificates have the same name. If you're at that point, you are better, because you have to fill the correct information on the DS-260. And again, guys, I told you, DS-260 is the original entry or is the original application for the for green card, because whatever you feel on that DS-260 is who they revise, is what they revise, and they take it that is who you are. So even if you had made an error on the original entry, but then you submit the you know, the correct information on the DS-260, they will revise what is on the DS-260. So once they revise on the DS-260, even if you had a mistake and you saw, okay, the KCC will submit your case to the consular officer with the correct information. So the consular officer will have in mind that whatever he has, the documents, when he's confirming the documents, if they are correct, then he can tell, even if you made a mistake, these documents you are submitting to the consular officer, he will tell that they have already been checked. The background check was done for the original things. So personally, I did the everything correct. Then once I attended the interview, actually I was surprised, because I was in my mind, actually I realized I omitted my name at the medical stage. After checking some friends and all that, I realized, oh, my case is different, my name is just missing. So at that point, now I was like tense. At when I attended the interview, I thought and I was expecting that the first question would be, why is your name? Why is your name different and all that? But actually, to my surprise, the consular officer never talked about the issue of the name. At all. He never asked me about how I omitted my name. Nothing like that happened. I guess I was very lucky. I'm grateful for that. Anyway, for those who have such situation, so you must maybe, if you are from a country that has low rate of, you know, fraud, you are good. But if your country from that is known with high rate of fraud, your case is at risk. But at the same time, I said, I know of some cases who had simple mistake, but they got denied. Again, I know of some people who had high risk, you know, all those combined errors and all that, but again, they got the visa and all that. So I'm not the one to confirm. If you're there, you feel like you can proceed, please go on. You can risk your money again and get your visa, and again you can risk and be denied. So it's up to you. The consular officer is the one to choose what he has to say about your case. So if you are there with some mistake errors on the names, personally I was there, and for me, even he never checked the name, and it was successful. So the key word here, or the key thing here, is fill the DS-260 with the correct information. That is what will be revised. That is the original application for the green card. So I hope this one is clear. And if you still guys have more questions on the name section, the mistakes on the original entry, but again, if you're there, you applied with an old passport, a fake passport, an expired passport on the original stage, that one you can't explain yourself, because if it was expired, it was expired. And you know, even if you have a new passport, once you are submitting the support document, they are requesting for that old one that you used on the application stage. So if they check the expired date and find that it was expired, then what do you think? So that's all for this video. And if you want to check about my experience, my story on how I won my green card, it's available. I think it's around 6 videos. The first video, I'll attach it on the end of this video. And every end of each video, there is a ring that takes you to the next level. So with that being said, guys, thank you for the support. And again, if you are there, you have a question on this section, please drop it on the comment section. I'll be more than happy to help you. So guys, thank you for subscribing. Please go on, subscribe, and share this video to your, you know, WhatsApp groups, or that on everyone you know who is confused, or someone who want to know more about the DV Lottery. And with that being said, guys, thank you, and see you in our next video.